Pax Branch Baptist Church was organized on June 10, 1911, with the organizing committee meeting in the Pax Branch School. The organizing committee included Reverend J.T. Painter, F.E. Pegram, and L.W. Webb from Mossy, J.L. Rogers from Oswald, W.A. Welcher and S.E. Kincaid from Mount Hope, D.V. and Eliza Argerbright from Oak Hill, Reverend Albert Williams from Maple Valley Baptist Church, and Reverend L.P. McClung from Kurtzville. The congregation for the new church was composed largely of members of Laurel Grove Baptist Church at Lively that lived in the Pax Branch community. Charles Billings and Addison Lafferty were appointed the first trustees of the newly formed church. Addison Lafferty was also appointed as the first clerk, while Charles Billings and Jack Rhodes were appointed as the first deacons. Construction of the church was a cooperative endeavor by several differing denominations. Reverend S.V. Argerbright, a retired Baptist minister, generously provided the major portion of the cash needed to complete the project. William Cruz, a member of the Church of Christ, donated the land for the church as well as timber used for the framing. J.A. McCoy, a member of the Methodist Church, sawed the lumber at no charge. Tragedy struck on November 12, 1954, when our little community church was completely destroyed by fire. But with resolve and determination by the members of the church and the wondrous hand of our Lord, Pax Branch Baptist Church was rebuilt. During the period of several months that was needed to rebuild the new church, Sunday school services were held in the home of Deacon Lundy Cochran, who was also one of the trustees of the church. Brother Walter Lewis and Brother John Williams were also trustees at that time. Sunday night services and midweek prayer services were held in homes of church members until the new building was ready for use. Upon completion, the new building for the Pax Branch Missionary Baptist Church was dedicated in a special service on Sunday, June 10, 1956. It should be noted that these services were held the same month and date that the church was organized 45 years earlier. Our little church in the mountains has experienced significant growth and required a larger building. The rebuilding of Pax Branch Baptist Church was completed in 1994. In 1998, a severe snowstorm damaged the church structurally and required significant repairs. This also provided the opportunity to again increase the size of the church. With increased blessings, the church saw the addition of a fellowship hall that was completed in 2003. During the past 100 years, Pax Branch Baptist Church has been served by 13 pastors. They are L.P. McClung, who served from June 1911 to December 1918, when he was killed in a tragic accident. W.T. Crum served from June 1919 to 1927. J.M. Hodges served from October 1927 to October 1929. J.B. Williams served from 1929 to 1931. Tom Shoemate served from 1934 to 1946. C.R. Brooks served from 1946 to 1950. John Denver Smith served from 1951 to 1955. J.L. Rogers served from September 1955 to 1959. Clarence Payne served from April 1959 to April 1960. Alexander Pishner served from July 1960 to 1969. Harmon Davis served from 1969 to 1975. Robert Scott served from October 1975 to 1988. And our present pastor is Samuel Vance, who has served since February of 1989. Our church remains a soul-winning station and supports more than 40 missionaries, including our home evangelist, Dale Vance.
There's a little mountain church in my thoughts of yesterday, where friends and family gathered for the Lord. There an old-fashioned preacher taught the straight and narrow way for what few coins a congregation could afford. Dressed in all our Sunday best, we sit on pews of solid oak, and I remember how our voices filled the air. How Mama sounded like an angel on those high soprano notes, and when the roll was called up yonder, I'll be there. Looking back now, that little mountain church house has become my life's cornerstone. It was there in that little mountain church house I first heard the word I based my life upon. And dinner on the ground, many were the souls that were revived. While the brothers and the sisters who'd gone on to glory land slept in peace in the maple grove nearby. Looking back now, that little mountain church house has become my life's cornerstone.
place dear to me, where I'm longing to be with my friends at the old country church. There with Mother I went, and our Sundays were spent with our friends at the old country church.
As a small country boy, how my heart would leap for joy when I knelt at that old country church. There with Jesus above and his wonderful love saved my soul in the old country church. Precious years,
precious years of memory.
Oh, what joy,
oh, what joy
they bring to me.
How I long
once more to be with my friends at the old country church. They'd only confess, Jesus surely would bless, as he did in that old country church.
Precious years of memory.
Oh, what joy
they bring to me.
How I long once more to be with my friends at the old country church.
I'm living for the Master from dawn till setting sun. I'm living for the Master until my life is done. He shed his life's blood for me on the hill of Calvary. I'm living for the Master because he died for me. Now others think I'm crazy for living this away, following my Savior up the long and winding way. They'd like to stop me in my tracks, but I just can't be stopped, for my belief in Jesus is as solid as a rock. I'm living for the Master from dawn till setting sun. I'm living for the Master until my life is done. He shed his life's blood for me on the hill of Calvary. I'm living for the Master because he died for me. They tell me that I'm dreaming, for he just can't be real. But let me tell you, brother, that's not the way I feel. I feel as sure as anything my Jesus still alive, and that he's gone and waiting in that happy home on high. I'm living for the Master from dawn till setting sun. I'm living for the Master until my life is done. He shed his life's blood for me on the hill of Calvary. I'm living for the Master because he died for me. I'm living for the Master from dawn till setting sun. I'm living for the Master until my life is done. He shed his life's blood for me on the hill of Calvary. I'm living for the Master because he died for me. I'm living for the Master because he died for me.
Gentle. just to know